The spring of 2002, I had bought my first new off-road motorcycle in quite a few years, and I bought a new product for it, this automatic clutch. And I loved what it did, but after a couple months of use, it started breaking. I was taking it out of my bike one night, kind of recognized that, you know, that some design problems in the clutch, and thought I could do something better. It's so difficult, I think, for a lot of new ideas to get off the ground, because someone may have a great idea, but they don't have the resources or the funds to take that idea into something that can then be proven. And TechHelp is a tremendous bridge for that.
The Manufacturing Extension Partnership, or MEP for short, is a nationwide program. Idaho's center is called TechHelp, and we're university-based, so we're a partnership of Boise State, University of Idaho, and Idaho State University. And we work across the state with small and medium-sized manufacturers to help them grow their businesses, to be more efficient, come up with new product ideas, to export globally, any way we can help those companies.
TechHelp, I got connected with a mechanical engineering student that had, you know, the SolidWorks software, and we were able to sit down and work together to make the product that I had envisioned.
In the course of 3 or 4 months, we had a design that was ready for prototype. We used some local machining resources and got functional prototypes on bikes and testing them in the field. So all that happened in less than 6 months.
I met Al in the spring of 2002. At that time, I was in my junior year at Boise State as a mechanical engineering student, and I had the good fortune to be selected to work at TechHelp.
At the time, I didn't have a lot of money resources either, and that was another really important part, is that TechHelp is a really great value as well. And it's great experience for the engineers. That engineer is now the president of Rekluse. TechHelp is really kind of a part of the Rekluse family. I don't think it could have started without it. And it certainly helped us to grow over the years.
Putting in new technologies on the production side has been a really big priority. Robotics has really allowed us to continue our acceleration and our growth.
A lot of people will say, like, you're just removing jobs. But really what we're doing is we're just changing the atmosphere of the job. So instead of having people come in and at a low level just loading into a CNC machine, now we're able to have people come in and learn robotics, and they learn different aspects, and then it just creates more technology-based jobs.
One of the things that's been inspiring and kind of unexpected is we've made the sport more accessible. You know, not only for people that, hey, I can get around on a clutch and I do just fine, but it makes it more fun. People that technically wouldn't be able to ride a motorcycle, whether they're disabled or have some sort of handicap, that now, hey, because of your product, I can ride a motorcycle.
Idaho is a testing ground for recreational technology products. If you love the environment, the opportunity to work closely with like-minded manufacturing companies, entrepreneurial, tenacious companies that are trying to change and improve rapidly, this is a good place to manufacture. If you're into the outdoors, it's even better.
Our economy is built on making things. And when we can't make things anymore and we have to rely on imports for everything that we do, you know, we just put ourselves in a position that isn't beneficial. It creates jobs. We're able to support local companies by, you know, purchasing from local suppliers. And more importantly, we get to employ Boise people to live here. It's a great place to live. It's a great place to dirt bike. And so it's a great place to be. It's a beautiful area. We have great management, and then the people that work here are amazing. They make a great product. People are stoked about it. So many wonderful things about this company.
The types of jobs that manufacturing bring into the picture, those are good jobs. People like to make stuff. People like to have an impact. You know, manufacturing, to me, is a great way to allow that to happen. Where we're at now, it's beyond what we probably could even have dreamed of, what I definitely dreamed of it potentially becoming. And to think about all the people involved here, inside the building that have been positively impacted by it. It's just really cool, and I feel really fortunate to be part of this team and be part of the journey.